Students, welcome back. Now coming to the next type of the transformation in the 2D, that is the rotation. So in the previous video, I explained about how the translation will be occurred in the form of changing of an object after creation. Okay, so now let's see the rotation. What is a rotation? A rotation, it is a process of changing the angle. So whenever you heard this rotation, rotation means it always comes with the angles. You can rotate the object in an angle, whether 90 degrees, 170 degrees, 260 degrees, 360 degrees, like that. It is a rotation. So it is a process of changing the angle, changing the angle of the object. Okay, suppose if you are sitting straight, okay, you are at a 90 degrees. Okay, means you want to move to the right side or to the left side, you have to be rotate. Okay, you have to changing the object, that is you're just rotating in 90 degrees or you're just rotating in 270 degrees, like that. Okay, so that is a rotation. A rotation, it is a process of changing the angle of an object. Rotation can be a clockwise. Rotation can be done in a clockwise or you can rotate the object in anti-clockwise. So rotation can be done in forward or in the reverse direction, clockwise or anti-clockwise. So for rotation, we have to specify the angle of rotation and the rotation point, that you call it as a pivot point. So it is print about which object has to be rotated. So let me take an example how the rotation will be done. Let coordinate of P in the polar form. Let's take x is equal to r cos phi and y is equal to r sin phi. So I'm just taking two coordinates, x and y. So this is a coordinate system. So here the P object is there, P x comma y. So I want to rotate this object into some angle, theta degrees. So which is my new line, that is a P dash, x dash comma y dash. So I rotate the object in this direction. So this is a original coordinate. So here the coordinates are r cos phi and the sine phi. So from origin to here, phi is the angle between the x axis and a point P. So here this angle is the phi. This is a phi. Okay. So here phi is the angle between, this is the x axis and this is the y axis, between x axis and point P, and from point to point P. So here the x coordinate is, you write it as r cos phi, and y coordinate is r sin phi. So here it is, r is nothing but distance from origin. So from here to here, the distance from origin, r is distance from origin to point P. Okay, so just remember this. Now I want to calculate x dash and y dash, means the new coordinates I want. So that is, then x dash is equal to r cos phi plus theta. Why I taking it as a phi plus theta? Because from starting from the x coordinate, okay, from x axis, this is the angle it rotated. Okay, so the phi plus theta, you have to take phi as well as this theta. So that's why x dash is equal to r cos of phi plus theta. And in the same way, y dash is equal to r cos phi plus sine, not sine phi plus theta. So x axis always will take cos theta, and y axis you have to take always sine. You are already learned this topics in the geometry. So whenever you are studying 7, 8, 9, 10th classes. So now let me solve. X dash is equal to r. I'm just substituting r cos phi cos theta. I'm writing the formula of cos phi plus theta. The cos phi plus theta is nothing but cos phi cos theta minus sin phi sin theta. Just r cos phi cos theta minus r sin phi sin theta. So this is nothing but x dash is equal to x cos theta. Why I am taking as x cos theta? Because x is equal to r cos phi. You know, x is equal to r cos phi and y is equal to r sin phi. So these are the initial coordinates. So in place of r cos phi, I'm substituting x, x cos theta, and in place of r sin phi, I'm writing y, y sin theta. So this is the new coordinate formula. X dash is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta. In the same way for y dash. So r sin phi plus theta is nothing but the sin phi plus theta formula is sin phi cos theta plus cos phi sin theta. So this is a formula for sin phi plus theta. Sin phi cos theta plus r cos phi sin theta. Okay. So r sin phi is nothing but y cos theta and r cos phi is x. So x, the remaining one is sin theta. So this is a y dash formula. So finally, you can say that x dash y dash is equal to cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta, cos theta into xy. So this is a formula for calculating this rotation, the rotation of an angle. So that is nothing but P dash is equal to R into P. So translation, you are doing the plus, and for rotation, P dash is equal to R into P. Okay, so I just written the coordinates here. The x coordinate is cos theta and the y variable term is minus y, minus sin theta, and here the x is sin theta and y is cos theta. So this is just nothing but the AB values. Okay, so let me take one simple example to explain this rotation. I'm taking an example. Oh, let me write one triangle is given 2, 2, okay, 8, 2 and 5, 5. So rotate the triangle 90 degrees. So they are asking to rotate the triangle 90 degrees. So 90 degrees you need to be rotated. Okay. So here theta is nothing but 90 degrees. So what is the original triangle they are given? The original one. Original one. So here let's take 6, 8, 10, 12. So what are the A coordinates? 2, 2. So here, and 8, 2. So this is 8. 8 is x coordinate and y is 2. 5, 5. So in between here to here. So this is A, B, C. This is the original triangle. So I want to rotate this triangle to 90 degrees. So how it is possible? Let's see. So here R is equal to cos theta, that is a cos 90 degrees, minus sin 90 degrees, and sin 90 degrees, and cos 90 degrees. Nothing but cos 90 is 0, sin 90 is 1, that is a minus here, and the sin 90 is 1 and the cos 90 is 0. Now calculate A dash. So A dash is equal to, so what's the formula? P into T, it means R into T, you can take like that. So here R is 0, 1, minus 1, 1, 0, and what are the A coordinates? The A coordinates are X, Y. So if you calculate, you get minus 2 and 2. And the same way, B dash, R is 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And what are the B coordinates here? 8, 2. So if you calculate, you'll get minus 2, 8. In the same way, C dash, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And what are the C coordinates? 5, 5. You'll get minus 5, 5. So XY values, XY values. Now let's take the new one. So the new one is after rotation. Let's see what is this. After minus 2, X is minus 2. Let's take minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, minus 8. So X is minus 2 means somewhere here. X is minus 2 and Y is 2. Okay. This is a point. And B, minus 2 and Y is 8 means somewhere is here. X is minus 2 and Y is 8. And coming to the C, minus 5. Minus 5 is somewhere here and the 5 is here. So this is after rotation. This is A value and this is B value and this is a C value. So see how the triangle is rotated. So the rotation is taking place in 90 degrees. So this triangle is rotated 90 degrees. So it comes like this. So this is about the rotation. Thank you.